Nkasi.
Ay, ay, ay. Oy, ni na wado.
Wato, Yesu.
So, apara. Adia,
waya, mame.
Adia, ya, 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 ye.
Dosu.
Uyame, uyame. Uyame, uyame, ufata. Ha, ha.
Aye.
Ye. Aye, vetie bezie, urani na ye, abeka fo ato yami, wa ye ye, ato
musu.
Fata,
Oh,
no, 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 Ampara, yes, In the name of Jesus, my beloved, we are still praying tonight. According to Job 38, verse 12. According to Job 38, verse 12. And I read, for the Bible said, God spoke to Job according to verse 12. Have you commanded the morning since your days began and called the dawn to know its place? Have you commanded the morning since your days began? Hallelujah. We all know the affliction and the trouble and the tribulation that Job went through. But God was expecting Job to command the commanding things, but Job couldn't come out. This very night, this very evening, we are commanding things to happen. But everything that you want it to happen right now, today, begin to command it. According to Luke 9, he called the disciples and gave them power and authority. We are telling God with the power. I command prosperity. I command favor. I command grace. I command things to work for me. Jesus, open your mouth and pray. We are commanding things to happen now. We are commanding things. The virus moving around. We are commanding it to disappear. We are moving on to our last prayer. We are telling God that any infirmity upon our life, we command it to move away. We command it to lose its hold. By fire, by thunder, we command the thing to have lived in the name of Jesus. We command the thing to lose its hold. For the Bible says, you command the moons in thy days began. Open your mouth, brethren, and begin to move it. Whatever thing that oppress us, whatever thing that put us down, by the name and by the blood of Jesus, we command the blood We deactivate every weapon, every oppression against our life. In the name of Jesus, any conspiracy, any agenda according to our family, by fire, by tender, let their plans fall tonight. Let their plans fail tonight. For the Bible says, no weapon formed against us shall ever prosper. I declare in the name of Jesus, any weapon that has been formed purposely for you, by fire, by tender, let that weapon fail. Let that weapon unfunction. I deactivate in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus,
amen.
As you have commanded the night, let everything work for us,
amen.
Let everything work in our favor, in the name of Jesus. May the spirit and may the angel take the possession. Let tonight be a night of testimony, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let all believers say amen.
Amen. In the name of Jesus, we command the release of the church. In the name of Jesus, we command healing. In the name of Jesus, we command breakthrough. In the name of Jesus, we command that tonight will be a night of testimonies. Amen. In the name of Jesus, we command that tonight, amen, the angels of God will descend in our midst. In the name of Jesus,
amen,
we command that the power of the Holy Ghost will be strong in our midst. In the name of Jesus, we command that God will hearken to his word and perform. In the name of Jesus, we command, amen, tonight to work in our favor. In the name of Jesus, we speak to the, amen, atmospheric realm. Let the element of the atmosphere favor us tonight in the name of Jesus. Let any living, amen, things on this earth favor us in the name of Jesus. Let the element, amen, of the coastal world favor us in the name of Jesus. We declare, amen, favor right now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We declare, amen, in the name of Jesus that tonight there, amen, is healing. That tonight, amen, whoever will come into encounter will feel the presence of God in the name of Jesus. We declare we are, amen, coming out of fear in the name of Jesus. Amen. We are coming out of, amen, oppression in the name of Jesus. We are free, amen, from depression in the name of Jesus. Oh, we come out of, amen, any demonic assignment designed for our life in the name of Jesus. Tonight we declare, amen, that our weapons are not carnal. They are mighty through God to the pulling down of any stronghold and anything that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, the plan, purpose of God for our life, in the name of Jesus, we pull it down. In the name of Jesus, we pull it down. In the name of Jesus, we speak to the atmosphere. Let any man or woman, oh God, that is hovering in the atmosphere, oh Lord, on assignment for our life, let them fall down in the name of,
amen,
Jesus. Let we,
amen,
not fall down in the name of, amen, Jesus. Let demonic powers lose their holds in the name of Jesus. We declare we are delivered in the name of Jesus. God bless you, prophet. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
In that same fire, we, amen, are ready to welcome our Papa, Reverend Papa Vincent, to lead us in the next 30 minutes as we continue to maneuver in the spirit and in the same prayer. Amen.
Amen. Okay, amen. Let's go into the word and read Revelation chapter number 4, verse number 1. I will dwell much in verse number 1.
Revelation chapter 4.
Chapter 4. Verse number 1. Revelation chapter 4, verse
there
number 1.
There is noise coming from a background. I can hear a child cry coming from somewhere. Please, let's control it. Revelation chapter 4. After this, I looked, and behold, a door was opened in heaven. And the first voice which I heard was, as it were, of a trumpet talking with me, which said, come up here, and I will show thee things which must be hereafter.
The Holy Spirit. After I look, this is a message from John when he had an encounter in the realm of the spirit on an island called Padua. And he said, in one of his encounters with the Spirit of God, with God the Father, with our Lord Jesus Christ seated on the throne, I looked and behold, a door was opened. A door was opened in heaven. A door was opened. Hmm. And the third voice that I heard was like a trumpet speaking with me, saying, come up here and I will show you the things that must take place. Come up. A door was open, and he heard a voice saying, come up, not come down, not stand still, but come up, meaning that move a step further. Tonight, where our prophet has taken our spirit to, we are moving a step further. Amen. So we are praying to God, oh Lord, take us to the next level. Take me to the next level. And elevate my spirit to the next level. Oh Father, increase my oil to the next level. Increase my faith to the next level. Increase my grace to the next level. Let my life be taken to the next level. I am tired of being stagnant at where I am. I am tired of marking time in my life. I am tired of repeating the same thing over and over in my life. Tonight, I pray with all the fibers and all the people. Take me to the next level. Let the door be level.
Bala 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 b Bala 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 b
Take me to the next level, Holy Spirit. Take me to the next level. Take us to the next level. Let's quickly read from the book of Judges, chapter number 16. Judges chapter 16, verse number 5.
You're reading Judges chapter 16,
verse number five.
Judges 16, verse number 5. And it says, and the Lord of the Philippines came up unto her and said unto her, entice him and see wherein his great strength lie, and by what means we may prevail against him, that we may bind him to afflict him, and we will give thee every one of us 1,100 pieces of silver. And Delilah said to Samson, tell me, I pray thee, wherein thy great strength lie, and wherein thou might be bound to afflict thee.
Come back to verse 4 so that we will get a certain concept correct. Verse 4.
That's
16,
Judges 16, verse 4. And it came to pass afterwards that he loved a woman in the valley of Sorek. whose name was Delilah.
Thank you, brother. God bless you. We've all heard the story of Samson. Very powerful man, anointed for a specific activity. We know the story. The most mighty man in those days. Great in strength because it was divinely gifted. He was divinely gifted. With all the power Samson had, Samson fell in love with a woman called Delilah. To Samson, he loved the woman. But there was something happened. Somewhere, somehow, the woman was polluted by evil thought and evil plot. The enemies of Samson polluted the love of Samson. The lover of Samson, so to say. The Philistines who hated Samson for everything he stands for, polluted what Samson loved. And so their evil plot to this woman, Delilah. So watch it. Delilah in the beginning wasn't polluted. Delilah in the beginning did not come to Samson with devilish mind. But somewhere, somehow, on the way, something happened which changed the ideas and the framework of Delilah. The Philistine polluted Delilah. And listen, when they bribed Delilah, they said to Delilah, please entice him, number one, and see where in his great strength lies. So what makes something unique? We want to know the secret, so entice him. They are using what Samson loves to entice him. I don't know what you are loving. You may love church, but they can use church to entice you. You may love money. You may love work. Look, whatever Samson was loving is what they used to entice you. We are praying tonight. Any polluted relationship, Delilah relationship, which is polluted, that relationship must die now.
In the name of Jesus.
Anything you love in church, but that thing has been polluted by the devil, it must die. It must die.
Amen.
It must die.
Amen.
Anything you love in work, at workplace, but it is polluted. Delilah knew her assignment from there on. Entice him. By what means we may overpower him so that we may bind him to afflict him, and each one of us will give you 1,100 pieces of silver. So Delilah is compromising the love Samson has for her with a price. She's taking a bribe. Delilah was bribed. Yeah, bribe with Delilah. And your cartoon actually will say, you win for so turn him away. Ma ye wuru ba bia na ho den wo na ye bu yara ebe ma usika, and Delilah accepted it. Verse number 6. So Delilah said to Samson, tell me where your great strength. That day Delilah bisa, based on the assignment, and now that the person will raise a lot of fire, any demon who is projecting him or herself to be your lover. Now, so, yeah, Paulu Tuno, why is it demonic bride to bring you down?
Yes.
To destroy you at the next level. You will not tolerate that. So what they are here, so what they are come up, what the soon sumwash yasye, what the hunemu and trisani, you will not tolerate that. The Lord will be saying something. If anyone who are
because of Grophobia bribers and yet you wouldn't have been. The name they were come out with the agent. Then, so a and uncle for the good ride. And I'm happy. End the Delilah relationship. Let the fire of God consume it. Let that relationship die by fire. Say free me busiamu. Say free me jebu siamu ne busiamu asolimu me jumbamu. Any part of my association upon some etumi a corrupting. Hey, one day Judas eko jisika. O free baby oko jisika ne ban. Na jine we ni tri me say. Me be pay Jesus na me yi na ma. Wouldn't die a polo to your loved one. With this prayer, they will be exposed.
Amen.
With this prayer, they cannot hide.
Amen.
With this prayer, they will confess. We came with an agenda. We were here to destroy you, but this fire, we can't stand.
In the name of Jesus.
Hold them before they destroy us.
In the name
we
of Jesus.
And declare any Delilah relationship, any relationship that has been polluted by demons, anything that we love, this is affected by evil purpose. We decree and declare, let it die by fire.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus, I command, O God, that your blood will not stand. I command, O God, that they will not prevail against me. In the name of Jesus, let any demonstration, O God, that I found myself associated with. In the name of Jesus, I wish you again in demonic relationships. I demonic companionship. I break any demonic associations. In the name of Jesus. Let any demonic association, let any demonic relationships in the name of Jesus that is strong in the spiritual realm, any demonic relationships in the physical realm, in the name of Jesus, let it break right now. I break any demonic relationship, I break any demonic attachment in the name of Jesus, relationship formed in the spiritual realm. Relationship formed in the physical realm. I break it right now in the name of Jesus. Pray somebody, we disconnect any evil relationship. In the name of Jesus, we disconnect any evil relationship. In the name of Jesus, we disconnect any
Die now.
Yeah.
Be the glory. Let every department of my life flourish. We decree and declare 2 minutes. Lift up your voice. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. The trouble of the devil. Enough.
That you breathe on our spirit in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray that you breathe on us in the name of Jesus. Fresh fire, fresh anointing in Jesus' mighty name. Manama shatala bala bala shatala ba. Rapa bala bala bala. Rapa bala bala shatala bala. Shandala bala 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 bala.
Better in the end of the matter than begin thereof. I decree and declare, as we have entered into the last week of the month, be the end of this month. May it be better in the mighty name of Jesus. May Amen. Each day in this week be better. May each minute in the day be better. May each hour in the day be better. May each second in the day be better. The enemy may waste us dead, but we shall come alive to declare the wonders of God in the life. In our lives, in the mighty name of Jesus, they were meant for evil, but God was what we are agenda and make it good in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever we have done, Lord, that is the light of prayer, Lord, darling, we welcome to the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Starting from the beginning, as our brother, our prophet, Emmanuel, led us to the level of the spirit, we see and declare every letter of fire. And every power fire we have released onto this platform, we shall celebrate the glory of God because we are more than conqueror in the mighty name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Everyone and everywhere you were listening and watching us and joining us, you are blessed and highly favored in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Amen. God bless you so much, Papa, for such wonderful ministration and leading us in the spirit as well. We have just 1 minute to exit our prayer line, so I'll make the announcement real quick. The big one is coming on the 5th of June. That's next week, Friday, our first ever online half nine prayers. And every first thing is a new beginning. So you want to partake in our first ever online half nine prayers. From 11 p.m. to 12:30 a.m. GMT, that's Ghana time, and 12 a.m. to 1:30 a.m. UK time. So you want to join us on the same meeting ID on Facebook and Instagram as well. And then again, we are meeting again on Saturday, from 9:30 to 10:30 GMT Ghana time to continue praying. And then we'll meet again on Sunday, same time, same meeting ID and same platform. So you want to invite your friends and family to join us wherever they are. We'll continue to pray in the name of Jesus. I will ask my friend, Prophet Yao Asumedu, to give us the benediction.
Okay, all right, man of God, we are praying. Father, we thank you for such a wonderful meeting tonight. Father, we believe that whatever word that we have spoken unto you has been answered. For your word says, when we pray, we should believe that we have received and we receive. Tonight, it is my prayer that let everyone on this platform be blessed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We pray even as we are about to leave online. Father, protect and guide us. Lead us through your wisdom and help us to overcome what we could not overcome.
Amen.
We thank you for blessing us and we give you the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Amen. God bless everyone. We will meet again on Saturday. Have a wonderful evening and have a good night as well. Bye, everyone.
God bless you.
God bless you. Bye. Too.